Hey guys, welcome back to the show. Today is the 23rd of February 2021, and the news is brought to you by Negative Supply, a company committed to revolutionizing the way you scan film. Spend more time making photographs and less time scanning by using Negative Supply tools. Their Film Carry Mark 1, Film Carry 120, and other tools are now shipping next day from their California headquarters. So, let's start the news. We have a new processor on eBay. This was sent to me by Nico, a Patreon, so thank you, Nico. And it seems to be some sort of roller system gizmo that's on eBay. So it doesn't warm up your chemicals, you can't put it in a water bath, but it's basically like some sort of Arduino controlled spindle that lets you spin your tank. One good thing it does have, it's programmable, so you can actually make it go faster or slower or only turn in one way and not do both ways. So it looks pretty cool, and price-wise, not too crazy high considering there's probably not a very high demand on it. So yeah. That's cool, and if someone has it or buys it, I'll also leave a link to a video where he shows a little bit of how it works. Very, very, very basic video and very basic eBay listing. Then we have a video again by another processor, the Diva, I think that's how you say it, by Adele, is finally made a video on in YouTube, which they show what details and things in the machine can do. Honestly, it looks pretty good. It has the whole 1 liter beakers. I think it has 6 beakers for 1 liter, has water in, then has waste out and also overflow out. It has its own autofill with water and tempering. It has a 7-inch a touch screen where you can like choose the program and it tells you what it's doing. Then you can also funnel the chemistry out. It cleans the tanks too. So it like pumps water and then flushes them. So I guess they have different systems. So the tanks that pump chemistry into your tank can also go all to waste or pump out. So, or pump, I don't know. It's pretty cool. Honestly, I watched the video. I highly recommend you watch it if you're interested in something like an automatic processor. And in the video, they develop E6, show you the rolls, the roll of 120. It's shot on 6x9 and it looks very good. So I hopefully, we will see a Kickstarter or them taking pre-orders in some way to purchase this machine from them, which is very exciting because I think the world needs automatic processors, and we have Midtones making theirs, and then you know, these Adele people making theirs. So cross my fingers, they will both come out and they'll be great. Then there's a new Kickstarter from the camera manufacturer Nons, and spelled N-O-N-S altogether. The SL42 version 2. So you might remember this was a camera that appeared like a year ago or so that was like a big chunky SLR, and it was shooting with M42 lenses or anything that you could adapt to M42, and it was shooting on Instax Mini. And the whole point of it was strange because this camera wouldn't cover the full frame. Not the camera, sorry. The lenses wouldn't cover the full frame, so you would get a circle with a very, very strong mechanical vignetting. Well, they've come out with a second version on Kickstarter with what they call the extender. And the extender basically is like an adapter that basically changes the focal flange distance. I made a video yesterday. I think I said it wrong. It's flange or flange. Flange distance. I might get it wrong. And it basically has a piece of glass on it, so it magnifies the circle from the lens and covers the whole frame of the Instax Mini. Good things about this project, in which I think we all should be more excited about, the fact that they make their own shutter. Okay, this is not some sort of like repurposed other camera shutter. It's their own shutter. A camera uses these lenses that also are being made by them. If you want, you can purchase it. I think it's $33 for the lens, which is ridiculous, but you can't buy it apart. It's a 51.8. Then they have their own speed booster, and I'm going to air quote that because that's not the name they give it, extender, that makes the coverage bigger, and then it basically shoots out Instax Mini. So if you like shooting Instax and you want a manual focus with a proper SLR, you're seeing what you're shooting and focusing, this is a pretty cool little invention. I actually have the first version at home from one of my Patreons sent me one, And I'll be testing it out very soon. But yeah, basically you get a super heavy vignette on the images. Then Film Washi seems to have gotten their hands back on their F135 X-ray film. And this time it's perforated at factory. So it's being perforated at wherever they make this emulsion. And he's received 9 kilometers of film. So that's a lot of work for Lomig. And he's gonna be spooling it into 135 canisters, and it'll be available at stores like Photoimpex very soon. So if you're waiting for that, I think it's ISO 100, but I'm not 100% sure on that. Then there seems to be the first peaked picture or leaked picture of a new lens from Leica, and this is a 35mm Apo f/2 lens. And Leica makes a 50mm Apo f/2 lens, which is around like $8,000-$9,000. Supposedly, it's amazing. And makes sense that Leica might make a 35 Apo too. This was seen at the website Leica Rumors. Like I said, might be a rumor, might happen, might not happen. But it's pretty cool to see that we might get, the Apo lens for 35. I'm a 35mm shooter myself, M2, most of the time. So yeah. Excited. I hope it's not $8,000. Then there's a new camera active V102 light meter. And I went onto the website because I found this on Instagram, went to the website. They seem to be selling like three or four different light meters that look like the same light meter in different casings. And I'm not 100% sure of this, but it does seem like it. This is the same light meter that's being seen in Alibaba and all these like Chinese Amazon-ish stores. This one, it seems to be the smallest so far and also the cheapest. It charges via USB-C and it's $45 if I was not mistaken, which is very inexpensive for a light meter. It still is a little bulkier than for the Reveny Labs, probably like twice as big. But maybe you like this smaller price tag for a light meter. Then last week I mentioned the After Exposure Broken Camera book and the Kickstarter. It looks like they've doubled their Kickstarter rewards. If anybody from the news did decide to back it, I would love to know. I'm very happy that they managed to get it. It seems like a very cool project and a coffee book, coffee table little book. And then the last thing. The Fujifilm rumor that I opened the other day, I got information from the same person that rumored about maybe the Minilab C41 chemistry being discontinued. It seems that it's not so much discontinued, but they have changed the brand name or the maybe discontinued the Fujifilm name and are now using the Fuji Hunt chemistry. So maybe that's what they're doing. I do know Fuji Hunt existed in the market and has been out there for a long time. Maybe Fujifilm is moving backwards and putting Fuji Hunt as the chemical brand for their mini labs. But if anybody has any more information, remember you can send an email to the email below. That's the news this week. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Bye.